invited public television's Welk show audience for a cruise on beautiful Table Rock Lake. So settle back and enjoy the trip. It's no coincidence that the show you're about to see has a riverboat theme, complete with a showboat and vintage costumes. But this is the real thing, and we're going to have a lot of fun on it during the breaks of this great Welk television show. Okay, mates, hoist the anchor, fire up the engines, start the bubble machine, and cast off.
From Hollywood, we bring you the Lawrence Welk Show. And now, your musical host, Maestro Lawrence Welk.
Well, listen to that audience out there. Thank you very kindly. You can certainly tell we have some relatives in the audience tonight. Greetings, friends, and a warm welcome. Our show this evening recalls those happy days of the showboats on the Mississippi River. And the fun starts with Alabama Jubilee. A 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, there was a bright opener, and how about those beautiful outfits? Jim Turner is doing a fine job for us and winning a lot of friends and fans with his great voice and his excellent guitar work. Here's Jim with a familiar, much-loved spiritual.
Deep river, my home. Over Jordan, deep river, Lord, I wanna cross over into campground. Oh, don't you wanna go to that promised land, to that promised land, where all is peace. Oh, dear,
That was very, very nice. Time now for some dance music, and we have a Hokey Carmichael song that seems quite fitting for the show. Up a Lazy River. Gentlemen, one and two and...
There's nothing more relaxing than a lazy river with a good book. Modesty almost forbids me to mention this, but Kelly Smeltzer, the assistant band director of the Jay County High School in Portland, Indiana, my hometown, recently wrote a master thesis all about me. And it's called Jack Imel, Lawrence Welk Performer Extraordinaire. And I just want to thank him for the great job that he did on it. The Portland Library arranged to have copies made of it for the public to read, and they had a big celebration for me and my family announcing its placement in their archives. The ceremony was held at the Theater Arts Building, and I was truly honored by an attendance of over 300 people. The book covers my entire show business career so far, and as you may have guessed, a very important man who played a major role in my life, my friend and mentor, the one and only Lawrence Welk. Thanks, boss. And here he is now with an introduction to Anacani and yours truly.
It's always a pleasure to introduce this next lovely lady. And this evening, Anacani gets some nice bagging by Jack Imel on the merimba.
The border down Mexico way, that's where I fell in love when stars above came out to play. And now as I wander, my thoughts ever stray.
wonderful as usual. And ladies and gentlemen, that fine marimba background by our associate producer from Indiana, Jack Imel. The Mississippi showboats always featured some great tap dancing, and our riverboat show follows in the same tradition. We're proud to present our own master of this art. Ladies and gentlemen, Arthur Duncan.
A song titled Southern Nights sounds like a natural for this kind of show. Bob Ralston sets the stage for our country gal from Tennessee, Ava Barber.
I spent a lot of Southern nights in San Diego when I was in the Navy during the war. I was with the Admiral's Band, and our military duties were in the realm of ceremonial performances along with morale building with music. The only real dangers I faced were the sailors who thought the guys in the band had it too soft. My Navy experience only firmed up my desires to be in show business. I won the All-Navy Talent Contest 2 years in a row, competing against 55 other finalists from the 11 naval districts of this country. I was asked to appear on the Ed Sullivan Show both times. along with the other nine runners-up. It sure was a kick, meeting the legendary Ed Sullivan and spending a weekend in New York City. I would have never believed then that only 2 weeks before my separation from the Navy, I would be hired right on television by another entertainment legend, Lawrence Welk.
On with the show, and we'd like to dedicate this next song to all of our good friends in the beautiful state of Florida. Let's enjoy it with Guy and Ralna.
The road of the rolling sea, moon over Miami, shine on as we begin a dream or two that may come true when the tide comes in. The song of the smiling troubadour.
Hark to the throbbing guitars.
Hear how the waves offer thunderous applause after each song to the stars.
Cakewalk was a famous old dance that was popular way down south in the last century.
It got its name from the dance contest where the first prize couple won a cake. And that's also where we got the expression, that takes the cake.
So here's the cakewalk and that old riverboat song, Robert E. Lee.
Thank you.
And here's a salute to the great state of Alabama. You'll hear the lovely voice of Kathie Sullivan with Bob Smale at the piano.
We lived our little drama. We kissed in a field of white. And stars fell on Alabama last night. I can't forget the glamour. Your eyes held a tender light. And stars fell on Alabama last night. I never planned in my imagination a situation so heavenly. A fairy land like a hammer. Your arms wound around me tight. And stars fell on Alabama last
night. Nice. Thank you, folks. And this week, I'd like to thank the Saturday Evening Post for saluting our 25th television anniversary and our musical family. This next song really doesn't need much of an introduction, especially to the folks in the South. Paul Humphrey, take it away.
Showboats like the Branson Bell are a big part of our country's entertainment history. They began as early as 1817, closed down during the Civil War, and really boomed at the end of the century, lasting until 1925 or so. In their heyday, they were magnificent floating show palaces with three decks, just like this one, navigating the winding and dangerous rivers, stopping at small towns all along the way. The showboats were often family-operated, and entertainments ranged from melodramas to song and dance shows, and sometimes even lectures and exhibits of nature's curiosities. Today, the showboat has been replaced with a cruise ship, and guys like me get on board for a couple of weeks and do their acts. I love performing for the cruise line crowds, following in the great tradition of American riverboat entertainers. And here's a salute to the Broadway show that memorialized him.
The great Broadway production showboat recalled the days of the Mississippi riverboats and gave us some wonderful songs. Let's enjoy a few of these fine songs with George Cates and the band. Look forward to those big band arrangements by George and the orchestra. Next, we bring you our very popular baritone, Tom Netherton, with another song by Hokey Carmichael. Neil Levang sets the mood.
Georgia, oh Georgia, the whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Georgia, oh Georgia, a song of comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the pine. Other arms reach out to me, other eyes smile tenderly. The road leads back to you, Georgia, oh my Georgia. No peace I find. Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia up.
Netherton, Neil Levang, and the orchestra. Mary Lou Metzger, Jack Imel, and company have a musical act that really rocks the showboat. Let's see what kind of reaction they get from Captain Ken Dilo.
Have you seen the show?
Yeah, we've seen it.
You know, what you need is something new.
Yeah, like ragtime.
Ragtime?
Yeah, well, that's all you hear down in New Orleans.
Well, it's the latest thing. Just listen to this. Hit it, boys.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss by wire.
Baby, my heart's on fire.
If you refuse me, honey, you lose me, then you'll be left alone. Telephone and tell me on your own.
One of my favorite numbers of all time. I had a chance to do a little singing, a little acting, and a lot of dancing. But you know, dancing's always been a lot of fun with Mary Lou, and not much work in teaching her the steps. Ken, well, that's a different story. Only kidding, Mr. D'Lo. I'd better be careful. He might have me thrown overboard. Over there is beautiful Table Rock Lake with its crystal blue waters and gorgeous shoreline. There's a lot of wildlife over there, too. Hawks, eagles, Canadian geese, deer. It's truly an unspoiled area and a real pleasure to look at. You can sure forget your troubles on the water. Another sure way to relax is with the Lawrence Welk Show. So take it away, Mr. Welk.
On with the show and a recent country hit. Let's enjoy it with the Aldrich sisters and the Atwell twins.
I'll be needing you.
I'm glad you like these youngsters. Our Riverboat show takes us to the Show Me State. And this next song was a special favorite of former President Harry Truman. Here's the band with the Missouri Waltz. Gentlemen, one, two, three.
Welk and Mary Lou Metzger, just a couple of smoothies. And by the way, that was a Bob Ralston arrangement. We find an extremely talented performer providing some unusual entertainment for our showboat audience. Let's meet Ken Dilo and a friend.
You know, being the captain of a riverboat all these years and traveling up and down that river, you meet all kinds of characters. Well, I happen to have one character I met a short time ago, and I brought him along today. His name is Allie. Come on up here, Allie. Hey. Allie and I have worked out a song, and we're going to do a little number for you now, right? Just start the music anytime, maestro. Now, Allie, I'm going to sing the first 8 bars, okay? Then you just join in. I met my little bright-eyed doll down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I met my little bright-eyed doll down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Come on, Allie, sing now.
I asked her for a little kiss down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. I asked her for a little kiss down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. She said, have patience, little man. I'm sure you'll understand. I hardly know your name.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Thank you.
I said, if I can have my way, maybe some sweet day, my name and yours will be the same. I went my little bright-eyed doll down, down, down by the riverside. Down, down, down by the riverside. Down, down, down by the riverside. I went my little bright-eyed doll down, down, down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. In the evening by the moonlight.
The moon's over here.
They keep moving that moon. I can hear those
did fine. You did great. Amazing.
The waiters on the Branson Bell are all young singers and dancers. And it sort of reminds me of when I was a kid. And now here I am, a grandpa. My wife Norma and I were presented with our 13th grandchild in 1995. My youngest son, Terry, and his lovely wife, Paula, became the proud parents of a 9-pound baby boy. And they called him Forrest Clayton Immel. Hey, it may not be too long before I'll be able to fill one of these showboats full of Immel family members. Chance to hear you sing. Why don't you sing a song for me now?
What do you want to hear?
We could do that
I'll
one
fly away.
Show.
Okay. Yeah.
I'll fly away.
I'll fly away. Sure.
Well, some bad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away.
On with the show, and here's the chance for our studio audience to get into the act. We invite you folks to dance as the band plays a familiar old favorite, South. One and two and...
Welk in the band with some swinging champagne music. You know, ladies and gentlemen, a riverboat show wouldn't be complete without a Stephen Foster song. Let's listen to Joe Feeney with Bob Ralston at the harpsichord.
Her merry voice would fall,
blithe birds that warbled them all. I dream of Jeannie with the light brown hair, floating like a vapor on the soft summer air. Many were the wild birds her merry voice would pause. Many were the blithe birds that warbled them all. I dream of Jeannie with the light brown hair, floating along.
That recaptures the spirit of those wonderful riverboat days. And here they are, ladies and gentlemen, Dixie. 1, 2, 3, 4.
White River Landing, and I just want to thank my friend Kenny Rogers for a ride on his beautiful showboat, the Branson Belle. And thanks, too, to the Welk family of stars for all their great riverboat music. It was sure smooth sailing down memory lane for me.